on today. Don't you love it? Here comes the class. And what age group are we today?
Third grade.
Third graders?
When you get in groups, sit. Last one to sit is it. Okay. All right, I want the middle person in every group to come get a color. One person from every group.
Excellent student management so far. No wasted time, right? They need one per person or one per group? Yeah, I thought that might be a communication issue.
I got us some orange, yeah.
Oh, we got orange too. Oh, foxtails.
Okay, who was the last group to sit besides these dogs? Was it y'all?
I think so.
Okay, pink is it. You want to try to stay away from these guys? They're trying to grab your flag out your pants. And the last team standing wins, okay? All right, ready? Go! Come on, dog.
So they have to stay within the basketball court?
Yes, stay within the green lawns. Okay.
I just took off in the corner.
That's okay. I was wondering if she was going to catch it or not. That's great. Look, Joseph ran off and hid in the corner so nobody would catch him. What would you do if you were a PE teacher in that situation?
Yeah, we'll bring down a
hand. No, if he's not hurting anything, you just let him stay over there. He'll get tired. He'll come over. He'll come back. What's he hurting? Right?
Yeah.
If he really needs attention that bad, 9 times out of 10, he's an elementary child. He's going to get tired of being over there not playing. He's going to come back on his own. Right? Okay. Let's go.
Did you put your flag pole? No? You just
no.
ran? Right?
No. He just...
Okay. You have to stay in the green boundary. Okay? Ready? Go. Pink team is in. Stay away from him.
That's pretty funny. That's pretty funny. Well, let him have it. Time to go to the next activity.
We're going to start out with the ankles. And what you're going to do is you're going to start off with both feet outside. You're going to hop in out, in, out, in, out, on. So let's try that real quick. And if you can do it at that level, just raise it up. You're gonna start with your both feet on the outside, hop in with one, out with both.
And this is called the what?
Korean jump rope.
This is the American.
This is the American?
This is the beginning one, right? Does anybody know what the Korean is? Mother, teacher, know what the Korean is? You want to demonstrate the Korean?
Jump up four times. And then you run on it like this.
Uh-huh. For four counts. Pay attention, guys.
Put those two together.
Is it where you jump across back and forth? I'm not positive either.
Like this?
Yeah, where you go all the way on this side, all the way across.
Like
no, as you jump in. Yeah.
Like
yes, like I think might be like.
Was it?
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I was talking about.
Oh.
So put it all together and let's see it.
All right.
So count it out.
Start off on the ropes.
Uh-huh. One, two, three, four.
Run on the rope.
One, two, three, four. Two, three, four. And then you start all over again.
Jump.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Well, or you, yeah. I think there's actually another one we're missing.
Awesome. Three. No, well, there was four, but I'm pretty sure he was using like a scissor.
Yeah, that's a scissor. Anyway, let's try that. It's in the little book that's on Moodle, all the descriptions of the different activities. So if you don't, not sure, make sure you ask me before the day of so I can look at it and show you. Try to do that up at knee level if you think it's too easy. Joseph definitely can do it at knee level, that's for sure. Three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And without the pauses. I said yes, without the pauses.
I was second guessing myself.
Yeah, too much. And this can be done with music. In fact, it's supposed to be done with music. And chanting, just like jump rope. Gets pretty hard to do when you get up at knee level if when you're not pausing. Three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Made it all the way through. Time to move to the next activity. You're behind about 2 minutes.
Okay. All right, everybody, just drop your ropes right there. Let's move over to Tinikling. Follow me.
Will this be the teacher that gets all the way through today? This is the question.
This is called the cross. Basically what it is you're going to have, it's just a little more complicated than the other one. You're going to have four beaters. So two beaters right here and two beaters right here. And you're going to have two steppers. So who wants to be a beater first?
Oh.
The beaters sit down around in your positions, around the pole.
There, look, there's some carpet squares in there if you want to kneel. If you go grab your carpet square, you can...
I can just kneel on here. I'm just not very...
Kind of hurts that kneecaps. You mean you're not really third graders?
Right here?
And if we had our other two people day, it would be so much better. We don't have a big enough class to have a class.
Okay, spread these middle poles out just a little bit. Okay. And what I want my beaters to do is just keep the beat. So the people that are sitting on the floor, what I want you to do is just the beat is bam, bam, pop, bam, bam, pop, bam, bam, pop. Get with me. Bam, bam, pop, bam, bam, pop, bam, bam, pop, bam, bam, pop. Now the steppers, what I want y'all to do is, you'll be like over here. It's pretty much the same step that you just learned, except you're just going in a cross. So you're going to be going all the way around. So it's going to look like this. Bam, bam, clap. Bam, bam, clap. Bam, bam, clap. Bam, bam, clap. You always want to lead with your right foot. So let's try that real quick. On my go.
With the beat?
Yeah, with the beat. We're not doing the poles, we're just working on the steps.
Oh.
Look at that agility. Do you need the poles a little wider? Yeah, spread them out a little bit, guys. He's got some pretty big tennis shoes. Why don't you come over here and beat and teach at the same time and let her up?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Okay.
That way she can see everybody and still beat. You know?
Okay. So you just want me to beat?
Yeah, get over there on the opposite of Taylor.
So you want me to go with her?
Mm-hmm. Everybody's going to have to beat. Come on.
Okay, let's try the beat. Okay, everybody freeze. Hold on. Okay, all the people sitting on the floor, I want y'all to do the beat with me. Okay, so one, two, three.
Spence, widen out your poles a little bit. Let's have the whole group do the same thing. So why don't you call it out and while they demonstrate it, right? So they can see it. So everybody tries to pause.
Okay.
Because it's nothing like seeing it.
All right.
Right.
We're all going to try it together. Everyone that's standing up right now. The beaters, just give me a beat. Yeah, let's go with a pause. Okay, so one.
Makes it a lot easier, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Okay,
rotate it.
Yeah, two more people.
Okay, one, two, three.
Oh, James, you got off.
Did everyone know this one?
Yeah.
Did everyone go up here?
Yes.
Okay. All right, now we're going to work on the beat. So it's pretty much... Yeah. Okay. It's the same thing, except you just have the poles on the top of it. The same beat. So you want to be with me? Okay, so... Bam, bam, clap. Bam, bam, clap.
Well, when you clap, do not pick the poles up. Keep them down.
Yeah, try to keep them low because they're already a little elevated.
Is it going to trip somebody if you pick them up?
Okay,
carpet squares because people are not really little kids, and it kind of hurts their knees. Your long legs, if you want to kneel on the carpet, it won't hurt your knees.
Okay, so on three. One, two, three.
Say it louder. Danica, get down here. That way you can see both groups without taking your eyes off your group here. Okay, say it loud enough we can keep your whole both groups together.
Okay. Okay, my feet is on me in the steppers. I want y'all to jump in on the third count, okay?
Very impressive. Y'all are the smartest third graders I've ever seen. It's still hard, even if you're in college. It's not perfectly easy, is it? The timing is a little... It.
Okay.
Yeah. You're right. Okay. On three.
One, two,
three. I believe it. How good is it? I brag too soon. Yes. One of your kids snuck out of class on you.
This one?
Yes, because you turned your...
Do I have to find it?
No, he went to the bathroom.
Oh, okay.
But he did sneak out of class on you.
Yeah.
Yep. That's okay. I'm not taking off points on the first lesson for that. Okay. They look good enough. You have gotten through what you had to do. Mm-hmm. So let's go back and review what they should have done. Let's do the line.
Okay.
Okay. I'm teaching the line.
All right. Just take the top two and move off
to the middle.
So we're just going to continue with the cross.
Yes. We're going to try to put it together since we're doing pretty. Hopefully, put it together. No, as in put the two lines in. Let's make a line out of the two. Okay. We don't need blocks. We can take the blocks away. Just hold the tops or stick your fingers in them. Don't hold them around this, all the way around. High school kids don't use the blocks. Do not stick your fingers underneath because they'll step on them. They'll smash your fingers. Okay.
Okay, so we need 2 liters at each hole and 2 steppers.
We may only have 1 stepper, huh? Because we're missing so many people. Everybody stand, put your right leg against, yeah, like copy him. Okay? Just like that. Okay, now tell him what to do. We're just doing the crossover step all the way down. I don't think you have enough time because I think we'll run out of time and have to switch lessons. Just go all the way down. Hold the poles out. She's not supposed to do this. I'm just throwing this in because we were supposed to do this the last couple lessons. Go across. James, jump in there. Joseph, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Let's put a pause in. You know, because I think we'll get screwed up if we don't. Right? Do it again. Do it again. Okay? Okay, 2, 3, pause. Okay, yeah, and then when you get down to the other end, then you do your circle and try to come back. So you three get up there. Come on, let's see if we can do it. Come on, I'll turn this off. Okay, see if you can get them to move together. Yes, let's pause for 3, cross for 3. Count it out, Danica, and get them together. They can beat. Oh, okay. I think we can beat. Yeah, because I think they're not really little kids.
1, 3. With the poles.
2nd teacher. That's the line in Tinikling. And we kind of skipped it because the cross actually comes next. But you're supposed to do the partner. Okay, if they get the partner, then they do the whole class, the line. Then after that, the cross. Then you put it all together. Okay, can you see that in your head?
Yeah, they make like a square because it's like lines 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then 2 and 3 move. And then like 1 and 4 move and it makes a square.
Yeah, and then you have a whole cool looking routine to music. Makes a great PTA demonstration for your class. Really does. Okay, is it Trey? Go.
All right, guys, everybody had a jump rope. Go. Go.
Is that one too long for you?
This one?
Uh-huh. That would probably work better. Yes. Yeah, they're great. They can handle anything you throw at them. I think our teacher should get extra points for his shoes. What you think? That gonna be missed in those. He's learning names of his students. I like that.
All right, guys. All right, the next one we're going to go over is the swing step, all right? Swing forward. So it'll be kind of like the step, but when you're on this one, kick this leg out, all right? So it'll look like this. Okay?
Is this the same thing we did last time? Kind of looks like the same step.
I think we just did the bird.
No, I don't think, but I think, didn't we do that? Can come out? Spence can really jump rope. I bragged on him, now he messes up. Ah, Mary can jump. Look how easy she makes it. That looks really nice. Joseph looks good too.
Next one we're gonna do is the same thing, swing step, but it'll be sideways. So it'll look like this.
Yeah, it's the same.
Over, out, over, out, over, out. Get it fly, right? Ready? Everybody ready? Okay. Go.
Lesson.
Everybody try to do this one, all right? Ready? Go. Give it a shot, all right? We're gonna jump our feet like this and land like this. And as we come right here, we're gonna switch back. Rotate feet in front, all right? So right leg goes in front the first time. Let's put it in the back the next time, all right? Let's give it a shot. Ready?
Look, she's got it. She's got it. Look how, oh, that was awesome. I embarrassed her. Do you realize the first lesson already has 54 hits on YouTube? Yep. Toe. Yeah, he's got it again. She's our jump rope girl, I'm telling you. Joseph can jump rope really well too. They're definitely our jump rope demonstrators.
Alright, the next one, it's called the toe touch, but it's backwards. Alright, so instead of touching in front, we're gonna jump and touch backwards, so it'll look like this, alright? A little awkward, all right? Let's try it out. Ready? Go.
Come on, football players can jump rope, right?
Oh. All right, good, good. Right now, everybody get on the line, face to the side. Stay on the line and face to the side where you can jump like this. And we're going to do a steer jump. And what we're going to do is, as it's over your head, you're going to jump to the other side of the line. Switch it up each time, all right?
Ski. Get ready for the Winter Olympics, right? Coming down that slope. Oh, look, piece of cake. Good job, Danica. Good, Reagan. Alexandria, good job. Until my camera got on you, huh? I messed you up with my camera. Taylor can jump. Mary makes it look like she's been doing it all her life. She's just so good. Look how smooth she is. Doesn't even make a sound when her feet hit. Don't tell me our heart rate's up. We hope we get a few steps in this class. Woo! The Kevin's makes it look easy too. Like patting your head and rubbing your stomach. We'll learn together, right? Come on, keep trying, guys. You might not get it the first time. Trey's got it. Look at the football player. He can jump rope. He's awesome. We have a skills test on this. We got to learn how to juggle at least for 30 seconds. 90% is with scarves, 100 with ball, softballs or any kind of balls, actually, or bean bags.
And eye coordination.
Yes.
All right, we're just going to review the cascade first. What are we going to do? Two in your right, one in your left. And we're going to throw, you take the one with two, throw one of those, then the one with the left, right, left, right, left, hopefully right.
He draws an X with his arms. Do you see the X?
Two.
Cross.
Try to get in a rhythm, it'll help more.
Cross your body, cross your body, cross. And toss it up a little bit over your head so you get enough time for it to come down. You don't have to rush that way.
Yeah, the higher you toss it, the more time you got.
Pretty good, pretty good. Oh, yeah.
All right, nice.
It's definitely easier than the first day they tried, huh?
All right, looks like y'all got it. This next one's called shower jumper, all right? It's kind of tough, right? You got to be quick. Let's, everybody put all your scarves down except for one, all right? Start up with one. What we're going to do is start with your left hand. We're just going to cross it over to your right, throw it over, catch it, cross it over, throw it over, catch it, cross
start
it.
Start off with your non-dominant hand for all your lefties.
You know. All right, now let's pick up another one. So you have one in each hand. All right, so take the one in your right hand, throw it over as that's in the air, pass the left one over to your right hand and throw it. Just like this.
Like a circle.
Exactly.
Keep it going. Keep it going. You pass it from your left to your right hand, throw it up with your right hand.
Hand it from your left to your right.
Throw. Don't throw it to your other hand. Pass
throw
it to
this
your
one over. Hand and as it it's to in the air, hand the other one to your other hand.
Yes, that's it.
There we go.
You know why they're having trouble? They are trying to change in their brain what you're doing because you're doing it opposite.
I don't want
right?
To
well, you can show them how to do it, and then you turn around just for a little bit. And let them
everybody
do it.
Watch. Throw it over, hand it to the other hand, catch it. Like a circle, like this.
Now they don't have to reverse it. See, you got it. Easy, easy.
All right, good, good. Now let's try three. I tried it last night and it didn't work out. But hopefully I can nail it right now.
1,000 repetitions to automate a skill. 1,000 repetitions to automate a skill.
What you're going to have to do right here is throw the one in you should have two in your right hand, all right? Throw the first one up, and as it's at its highest point, throw the next one up and then hand it over, all right? So it should look something like this.
Throw. You are great. What a wonderful demonstration.
Nice. All right, let's give it a try. Throw them both up first. There you go, dude.
Okay, everybody in.